Franchise Asia Philippines 2013 conference will resume in just a while. Please return to your seats now. Thank you.
year.
Welcome back to Franchise Asia Philippines 2013. We're down to our last session today, and this promises to be another lively discussion between leading franchisors and franchisees.
You know, you talked about a franchise being like a marriage, and you know, with a marriage, trust is one of the bigger issues. And what do you think about this trust between franchisee and franchisee? A news channel. Ladies and gentlemen, a warm round of applause for the beautiful Miss Isa Liton.
Thank you very, very much, Joey. Nice to see you again in
nice
this
to
Hi, good afternoon, Gabby, and good afternoon to everybody here attending Franchise Asia 2013. Wow, you know what? It's been a pretty long day, I'm sure, because everyone has been so attentive, listening to so many interesting topics to kick off Franchise Asia 2013. It's an absolute pleasure to be back here today, moderating the last and the most heated forum, pinaka-aabang ang forum na to, because we're going to be talking about franchisor and franchisee relationships.
You know, Isa, as most people say, franchising is like a marriage. Between franchisors and franchisees, and the success of both of these, you know, the franchisor and the franchisee, is similar to marriage. It has to be happy, successful, and long-term.
Yes, definitely. And oh, by the way, before we keep going on to what's going to happen this afternoon here in the forum, hi, of course, to our lovely heads, the executives of PFA. Hi, Mr. Rapa. Hi, Bob.
I'm Miss Bing.
Yes, and where's Sir Sammy Lim? Is he still here? Everyone's around, I'm sure, because after all, it's a kickoff of the next 2-3 days. Thank you very, very much for having us. We're just wanting to diffuse, of course, the fact that there's been absolutely one speaker after another, all experts, I'm sure, in their fields. But for the last forum, this isn't about us. It's about you. This is the very reason why we have Franchise Asia and why this particular forum is actually the last in the day, in the first day. Because you want it to be a very open venue to hear both sides out. And that's one of the best relationships you can have, which is the franchisor and franchisee relationship. You compared it to a marriage. Well, in this to start off the forum, I don't want to call it necessarily the do's and don'ts, because there are no rules, really, when it comes to a relationship. It's a give and take. Okay. Mutual respect and trust, right?
Yes, I do trust you, Isa.
If ever we're married. I'm sure you're among friends here. Everybody having a good afternoon so far? Everybody looking forward to this particular forum? I hope so, because we want to hear from you, both franchisors and franchisees. I'm sure you have pens and papers. I'm going to try to invite you to come over to the mic later on so you can ask your questions. But just in case you're shy, don't worry. That's what Gabby and I are here for. Write your questions down in pieces of paper, and our lovely coordinators or event people will be getting those pieces of paper from you, and I and Gabby will gladly ask those questions. So why don't we get going, Gabby? Who's our first panelist this afternoon?
Okay, our first panelist holds a bachelor's degree in chemical engineering cum laude from the University of British Columbia in Vancouver, Canada. He's a leading authority and advocate on alternative fuels. He spearheaded the selling and promotion of biofuels in the Philippines. He is credited for successfully steering his company to the downstream oil industry following the oil deregulation in 1997. And now he is at the helm of the country's leading and largest independent fuel company with a network of over 340 retail stations nationwide. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a big hand to the President and CEO of Sea Oil, Philippines Incorporated, Mr. Francis Glenn Yu, CFE.
Good afternoon, Sir Glenn. Come on down, join us. Still on the side of franchisors, the next speaker holds a Bachelor of Arts degree, major in economics from San Beda College, Manila, and a Master of Entrepreneurship degree with distinction from the Ateneo Graduate School of Business. He has several stints in various industries, from manufacturing to food retail, covering over 15 years of work experience in corporate planning, marketing, and operations and strategic management, we have with us the general manager of Mr. Donut, Mr. Jerome C. Tubulig.